society, you know what I'm already talking about. Intuitively, you already know what I'm going to say. At the same time, this time last year, I was in Sri Lanka with Dr. Aryaratne, and we were facilitating a million person in meditation. Just last week, I was in Jena, 2 days ago, I was in Jena, Louisiana, speaking to a rally. Speaking to the fact that the justice system was on tilt against people of color and poor people. And now I'm here speaking with you, and it's interesting to note that though the groups seem different and diverse, it's really all one group. History makers. Individuals who are not sitting idly by waiting for the world to change, but making an internal stand and being the change energetically and participating in the world that we want to see. In other words, you and I are not anticipants waiting for the cosmic tumblers to click into place, hoping that the world will become better one day. You are participating in the energy of the way you want it to be. This is what it's all about. So from this moment on, don't anticipate peace. Don't anticipate good. Don't anticipate love. Participate in it. Every time you love, every time you have compassion, every time you release a joy, every time you forgive, you are participating in the realm of ever-expanding good, which is another name for heaven, and downloading it through your word, your thought, your action, and even the work that you do on the mat makes a difference. Some would ask, is peace possible?
Yeah.
We know that a thought, an energy that emerges from the consciousness of unity is hundreds of times more powerful than a thought that emerges from a sense of a separation. So the moment you release that standalone quality, you are releasing the peace that the world is anxiously, anxiously anticipating, but you're participating in. In other words, in this moment, take the breath here and feel the peace. You're not to ask, is it possible? You're to say and come to an awareness that if you're not actively participating and downloading it, you are not in integrity with your soul. You are a bystander waiting for evolution to take place rather than consciously participating in the evolutionary impulse that's governing the universe. You are here to joyously participate, not sell out on your soul, not acquiesce to business as usual, not believe that things are so bad that it cannot, you cannot make a difference. You are to hold fast to these qualities. You are to be consciously idealistic and creatively naive to believe that your one little life can make a difference on this planet. And as two and three and thousands of us come together, of a world that works for everyone, we will create a vibration that will tear down the Jericho walls of separation, bigotry, racism, lack, limitation, poverty, ecological destruction, and begin to manifest a world that's held in the mind of God, waiting for you to capture it, articulate it, live it, dance it, sing it, reveal it in your postures, so that from this moment on, everything will unfold in a most glorious way. Why? Because all things work together for good for they who love the Lord, the great law of life, and live it in every step. That's all that I have to say in my 5 minutes. Peace and richest blessings to you. So I would invite you to do this. Just touch somebody's hand for a moment. Feel the energy moving through that hand. The prana, the life, the chi, the God presence. Close your eyes for just a moment and feel yourself participating in the evolutionary impulse that's governing the universe. Feel yourself participating in that which is trying to emerge at this time in human history through the history makers right here and right now. Feel it in your soul. And know that as I am speaking this very word of prayer, when not begging or beseeching a reluctant deity outside of ourselves. No, we are announcing and proclaiming and affirming and knowing that the word that I am speaking is a law unto itself that only knows its own fulfillment. And that these individuals are duly deputized by the Spirit of the living God to be the ambassadors of what's trying to emerge at this time in human history. That as this word is being spoken, the entire universe is celebrating, for it has found a place to express itself. That would be us, that would be here, that would be now. We wouldn't give thanks for this. We feel good about it. We know that the entire universe is conspiring to release its own energy through this moment. And that from this moment on, everything is working together for our individual and collective good, and we let it be. Now, right now, when?
Yeah.
When?
Yeah.
When?
Yeah.
Right now! It is done!